Sean King reposted a video on his social media where a white man answers the question, why can't you be proud of being white? King defended the video by saying, it's important for white people to answer questions like this for other white people, calling it one of the most thorough, down-to-earth, practical responses. In the video, the man whose name is Michael and a Florida filmmaker breaks down the term black and white pride and explains where they originated from.
I knew this question was coming and I waited until someone asked it nicely to respond. So no, there's no such thing as white pride, in part because there is no white culture. You can have pride based on your ethnicity, like Scottish, German, Irish. You can even have regional pride, like Southern pride. These things usually apply to your cultural identity, like how you grew up, etc. And I had some people argue, well, other colors have pride, and no, they don't. Chicano, Latino pride, Asian pride, those are not colors. The one exception is black pride. And that's because they've had a unique experience no one else has. Black Americans were robbed of their culture. They don't know where they come from. Two black Americans meet. They could have come from warring African tribes. They don't know. What they do know is their American experience was similar. In other words, the thing that connects them is the color of their skin and how society has treated them as a result. You also have to consider where the terms white pride and black pride originate. White pride was coined by white supremacists. Black pride is from the Black Power and Civil Rights Movement. So one represents superiority and hate, and the other a fight for equality.
Today we have Comedy Hype analyst Rita Brent calling in to give her thoughts on Michael's statement. Rita, first and foremost, thank you for joining me today. After watching that video, what are your initial reactions?
Well, I agree with somebody in the comments who said Michael is invited to the barbecue. I mean, that was, as long as he don't bring no barbecue ribs or raisins on him. But that was a wonderful explanation. He really covered a lot in that 60 seconds. And the idea that white pride, to me, is coupled with white supremacy is very true. Because I would like to know, for those who exclaim white pride, actually, what is it that you are proud of? You know, are you proud of the wealth gap that was created from slavery? Are you proud of your Confederate ancestors who were fighting to keep slavery? What exactly are you proud of? Are you proud of your hair and your names that get you the jobs that we are also qualified for, but don't get because of our names and our hair? I would just like to know exactly what is white pride? What is it? Because whiteness is the standard already. So you don't have to exclaim white pride because we abide by everything whiteness in the world already. What are you proud of? The fact that you get to make the decisions for people's lives and women's bodies in the House and the Senate? I would really just like a genuine answer to that question. When you say white pride, what is it that you are exactly proud of?
Do you think there is any possible way to have a healthy way of being proud of being white? Like someone that, you know, they think it's unfair that black people are able to fully express, you know, I'm proud to be black. I'm black and I'm proud. Those type of things. So for people, do you think there's a way for someone to be proud of being white, but in a healthy way that's not racist?
Well, it's much deeper than that. I mean, we're not talking about being proud of pumpkin pie versus sweet potato pie. That's not the kind of pride we're talking about. When we talk about white pride, it instantly, for us and for many of my ancestors, for my grandmother, who I just had a conversation about segregation with, it comes from white supremacy. We're talking about the burning of crosses. That has been equated with white pride. We're talking about segregation. We're talking about bombing homes and things like that. So the examples that we have of white pride right now are all equal to hatred and racism and discrimination. So they're going to have to find a way to change that narrative, because for us, black pride is completely different. It started for us as a movement. Black is beautiful, black power, Black Panthers back in the day. For us, it is an exclamation that we are worthy. We are proud of the hair that grows out of our head. We are proud of our skin color. Our skin color is not a crime. For us, it's a thing of validation. We are trying to get it in people's head that we are worthy when we say black pride. Now, to my knowledge, there are no examples of enslaving and oppressing when we're saying black pride. We aren't burning crosses. We aren't throwing neo-Nazi salutes and Hail Hitler and things like that. So if they want to say white pride, they need to change the narrative, because right now, white pride to me means white supremacy.
And for anyone that's wondering, when we're having to say these things to kind of, like you said, validate to other people, like letting you know the intelligence that we have, or, you know, the beauty in our hair, Why is it that you think that we have to push Black pride?
Well, because it has not been the standard. And if you look at anything today on Twitter, there's still all kinds of examples of us being called the N-word. You know, even the idea of us saying that we are Black, you know, that's not just, it's not just a skin color thing. It's a culture thing. You know, when we talk about being Black, this has come from the past. Some of us identify as Black. Some of us choose to identify as African American. Some of our ancestors prefer to be called Negro over colored. It is an identity thing for us that we have been struggling for so freaking long. And so when you are the standard, you don't have to say white pride, because everything surrounds and evolves around whiteness in the world. So for us, we're trying to come up. We're trying to say, hey, just because I'm Black and I walk down the street in a hoodie, I'm not a threat. Let me be right. Proud of my skin color. Hey, just because I'm Black and I'm taking a jog through a neighborhood, I'm not a threat. You know, so when people see Blackness, they see inherent violence. So and according to the president, they see crime, they see poverty. So we're trying to change the narrative when it comes to Blackness. And when we say Black pride, we're just saying, hey, that we are worthy and we deserve to be here too.
And question for you specifically, is there a reason that you can think of, you know, that someone could say the reason why they're proud of being white that would validate it for you? Like, is there anything in mind that you can, like, you would accept as like, okay, that makes sense?
I'm proud of being a white person who is not racist and who is standing for the rights of all people, because, you know, I have white friends who are supporters of Black people. They're supporters of the Black Lives Matter movement. You know, they understand the struggle. Well, they can't empathize, but they can sympathize. So right. If you are a white person who acknowledges that you have privilege, because white privilege is a thing. I know there's this idea of Black privilege and Black supremacy, but I still ain't experienced none of that. So if a white person is a person today who is identifying themselves as an ally and somebody who is saying, hey, I treat people as equal, whether you are Black or whatever color you are, that's something that you can be proud of. If you're trying to make a difference and fight for justice and equal rights, that's something you can be proud of. But not flying the Confederate flag and burning crosses and things like that, which I equate to white pride.
Well, I definitely appreciate you calling in to give your thoughts on this. Rita, now we want to hear from you down in the comments below. What is the difference between Black pride and white pride? And do you think that we're able to have pride in both Black and white communities? For Comedy Hype News, I'm Symphony Thompson.